telecast, God has a word for you, and I'm Pastor Aminata, and we're getting back to our teaching. Jesus is the boss, and we're just the employee. Or should it be employees? I'm not exactly sure, but you know what I mean. And our running scripture is Matthew, the 9th chapter, verse 37 and 38. He said to his disciples, "The harvest is great, but the workers are few. So pray to the Lord who is in charge of the harvest and ask him to send more workers into his field." So as I shared with you the last time, you know, part of our job is to continue the mission of Jesus Christ. And some of the tasks within that mission is, one, to make disciples. Remember, he said, go and make disciples of all nations. Acts 2, verse 41 and 42. Those who were baptized, those who believed what Peter said, were baptized and added to the church that day about 3,000 in all. Could you imagine, all right, the authority and the power of the Holy Spirit working through Peter, so much so that those who heard it believed and were baptized, about 3,000 people. That's what I'm talking about. That's what we want to have happening today. Verse 42, all the believers devoted themselves to the apostles' teaching and to fellowship and to sharing meals, including the Lord's Supper, and to prayer. Oh, all the believers devoted themselves. See, the teaching is so important, especially when you have new converts. All right? We just don't take it aside and say, oh, yeah. Sometimes when you see me stop like this, because I know I'm getting ready to get myself in trouble. But it's not enough to say the doors of the church is open, because a lot of churches, and I've seen them sat there where they want to build church membership, but not necessarily kingdom membership. Because if you invite people to accept Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior, and then you don't commit to teaching them, I'm not just talking preaching, but you must teach them, all right? Because that's how you become empowered, through the teaching, through the explaining of God's word, not the proclaiming of God's word. The proclaiming of God's word is what draws them, but it's the explaining of God's word is what keeps them. So when we look at Acts the 14th chapter, and you should go and read it, because Paul and Barnabas was at the city, and they too were preaching, and they were so powerful that the people thought they were, you know, Greek gods in human form. I think they thought Paul was Hermes and Barnabas was Zeus. But just go to Acts the 14th chapter. I just want to start at the 15th verse. And it says, "Friends, why are you doing this? We are merely human beings, just like you. We have come to bring you the good news that you should turn from these worthless things and turn to the living God who made heaven and earth, the sea and everything in them." Because again, these people were worshiping false gods. And Paul and Barnabas was preaching, and their preaching was so awesome that they actually thought that they were the Greek gods in human form. Acts 18 and 8 says this, "Crispus, the leader of the synagogue, and everyone in his household believed in the Lord. Many others in Corinth also heard Paul, became believers, and were baptized." Our mandate, make disciples and to share the good news. Tell people that there is forgiveness of sins. Tell people that they too can have the right to eternal life if they accept Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior. Our mandate is to go and make disciples of all nations. Not just enough to tell them to accept Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior, but they too will have a job that they have to do for the Lord. If we do this, we will always be about our Father's business. There's work to do, and there will always be work to do. You know, we got to reach them, all right? We got to bring them in. We got to clean them up. We got to teach them. We got to train them. We got to send them out and bring some more back in. So it should be constant, not just church membership building, but kingdom work, kingdom building. Romans 10th chapter 14th verse says this, But how can they call on him to save them unless they believe in him? And how can they believe in him if they have never heard about him? And how can they hear about him unless someone tells them? Well, we can't take it for granted. Oh, well, everybody should know who Jesus is. Do not take that for granted. All right? So the thing is that will you be a witness for the Lord? Will you be an employee of Jesus Christ? Will you accept Jesus Christ as your boss? And knowing that you are his employee, knowing that you are his doulos. You know, if you want to call me anything, call me doulos. I'll answer. All right? I am his slave. I am his servant. Verse 15. And how will anyone go and tell them without being sent? That is why the scripture says, how beautiful are the feet of the messengers who bring good news. All right? As a messenger of the Lord, as a servant of the Lord, as a slave of the Lord, I'm just here to bring you good news. I'm just here to share the good news and the gospel of Jesus Christ. I am here to let people know that you can have comforter, you can have a savior. Mm-hmm. But also, if you accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, because he needs more workers in his field. Mm-hmm. He said the harvest is plenteous, but the workers are few. Because he needs people who are committed and dedicated and to serve him. I'm going to stop right there because I'm about to get in trouble again. I'm going to stay focused this time. I'm doing good. 1 John chapter 1, verses 2 and 3 says this. This one who is life itself was revealed to us, and we have seen him. And now we testify and proclaim to you that he is the one who is eternal life. He was with the Father, and then he was revealed to us. Verse 3. We proclaim to you that we ourselves have actually seen and heard, so that you may have fellowship with us. And our fellowship is with the Father and with his Son, Jesus Christ. All right? So again, in this John now talking, that he was an eyewitness, and now he's sharing what he has experienced, what he saw with his own eyes. And this is what the Lord expects from us. We are to be witnesses to the world, to let them know that Jesus lives, that Jesus saves. And I can testify to that. You know, as they say, once I was lost, but now I'm found. I was blind, but now I see. Mm-mm-mm. All right. So, again, our mandate is to preach, teach, heal the sick, share the good news, make disciples of all nations. Matthew 10th chapter, verse 7 and 8 says this. Go and announce to them that the kingdom of heaven is near. That should always, you know, it's like Jesus is coming back. Will you be ready when he comes back? Mm-hmm. Do you want to be left behind? Do you want to go to hell? Yes, hell. Let people know that hell is real. Not just, oh, well, I got hell here on earth. Honey, I'm not saying that you ain't experiencing a form of hell on earth, but you ain't experienced hell in and of itself. And do you really want to? I don't think so. Verse 8. Heal the sick, raise the dead, cure those with leprosy, and cast out demons. Give as freely as you have received. All right? Give as freely as you have received. Heal the sick, raise the dead, cure those with leprosy. Really heavy stuff. All right? But this mandate, this charge from the Lord, is for you and I. If we are about our Father's business. All right? And then we can, you know, look at each other and wave or wink at each other as we are about our Father's business. Knowing that Jesus is coming back, we know not the day or the hour, so we need to get busy. I don't know about you, but payday, they used to sing back in the day when I was little in church, put your time in, because payday is coming after a while. Ooh. Mark 16 and 20 says this. And the disciples went everywhere and preached, and the Lord worked through them, confirming what they said by many miraculous signs. Yes. You know, the miraculous. I know this. There's some who don't believe that signs and wonders are for today, but I don't know what Bible they be reading. All right. But when you are walking in the authority of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and the Holy Spirit is leading you and empowered you, yes, there will be many miraculous signs. He will work through you. Wouldn't it be awesome? All right? But that only comes when you are an obedient child of God, when you are a dedicated doulos, a dedicated slave, a dedicated servant, when you understand that there is no you, all right? There is no you enslaved. Nope. All right? That this is not your agenda, but this is God's agenda. And that the mission that you're supposed to be on is to continue the mission of Jesus Christ that he was on. And he made it clear, I came to do the will of my Father. Got to come back one more time, stopping right here. I'm Pastor Aminata. God has a word for you.
If you haven't yet accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, let's do so right now with this prayer of salvation. Pray after me, but it's more important that you're sincere and that you believe it in your heart. Father God, I believe your word, and your word says in Romans chapter 10 that if I confess with my mouth the Lord Jesus and believe with my heart that God has raised him from the dead, that I will be saved. So right now, I put my trust in you, Jesus Christ, as my personal Lord and Savior. I admit that I'm a sinner and I need God in my life. I believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of the living God who went to the cross to wash away my sin. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. If you prayed that prayer, I want you to email us and let us know, because right now you're saved and the angels in heaven are rejoicing. And do yourself a huge favor and pray that God would lead you to a Bible-believing church where you can continue to grow in grace. God bless you.